Today topic is a fluid mechanics. So in fluid mechanics, in nature, matter exists in three forms. One is a solid, liquid, and gases. So in solid, the intermolecular forces are strong in solid, so the shape and size of the solid do not change easily. So the intermolecular force will be strong here, and shape and size do not easily change. But in case of the liquid, the intermolecular force is a less as compared to solid. So the shape can change, but not size, because density is difficult to change. But in the gases, the intermolecular forces are very small, so easy to change the shape and density. Okay, so now I am going to first define pressure. What is the pressure? So you know, pressure is a, you can define pressure as a force per unit area. So limit delta A tends to 0 and force upon per unit area. So the definition is the thrust exerted by a liquid at rest per unit area of the surface in the contact with the liquid is called pressure. So if you take container here, and if you take liquid in this container, okay, so the pressure act in each wall is P1, P2, P3, okay. So pressure act in all direction, okay. If you suppose that you take one cylinder here, force is acting in this is F, and this area is A. So the pressure will be force per unit area, force per unit area. And the pressure in liquid act in all direction. That is a reason pressure is a scalar quantity. Because you can see force is a vector, area is a vector. So why pressure is a scalar? Because pressure acts in all direction. That is the reason pressure is a scalar quantity. Now I am going to derive the formula for pressure in the liquid. Suppose you take the container, okay, and take the two points here. One point is A, and suppose that if you have a liquid here, okay, and another point is here B, okay, and the cross section area is suppose that delta S. So you know, at rest you can say, or you can say at equilibrium, net force will be zero. So suppose that this layer of liquid height, I am just supposing delta Z, okay. So this layer in equilibrium, so the force acting from the top, this will be FA, and force acting from downward, that will be FB. So at equilibrium, force acting from downward is balanced by the force acting from below in upward direction. So FA plus weight of, suppose that this is the A, B, C, and D. So the weight of A, B, C, D section of liquid this equal to FB. So how to find the weight? You know, weight you can find by rho V G. So this is the density, and volume you can write cross section area multiply by DZ into G. And how to write FA? So force at A point, because suppose that pressure is a P, multiply by delta S. And what about the force at B? So this pressure will be P plus delta P multiply by delta S, because I'm supposing here force is a pressure is a P, and when I go into the liquid delta Z depth, so pressure will be P plus delta P. So the P plus delta P, and here pressure is a P. So now you can write P plus delta S equal to rho delta S dz into g, that equal to P plus delta P into delta S. You just cut, and then you have dp equal to, you can write here dp equal to rho g and dz. So now integrate here. Suppose that if you have pressure at A point is a PA, you can see rho is a constant because incompressible flow, and here your z equal to 0, okay, and this equal to z, and here if you have PB, so I'm taking here g, this is a 0 and this is a z, so you can write PB minus PA, this equal to rho g dz, sorry, rho g z. So at any point, pressure at any point B equal to PA plus rho g z. It's only depend on the z is a height. So suppose that if you have any container here, and this is filled with any kind of solute liquid, density is a rho, and this height is a given h. So what about the pressure at this point, A point? So the pressure of A point is, this is the here atmospheric pressure, because suppose this is the open section, so the atmospheric pressure is a P naught plus rho g h. Suppose another point, suppose that if you have a pipe and here pressure is acting, suppose that is a PA, in this direction pressure is acting, suppose that PB, and cross section area is here delta S, here is also delta S. So at equilibrium net force equal to 0, so the PA into delta S, this equal to PB into delta S. So now you can write PA equal to PB. So the important point is, at equilibrium, okay, liquid in, suppose in a rest, so the pressure is same at two point in the same horizontal level. So if you have any this type of, suppose that I'm taking different, okay, and if you have here some different density, rho 1, rho 2, here you have suppose a different density, okay, that is the reason you have different level. So take two point, actually this is the A point, suppose that here this is the A, and exactly in the level if you take the another point, that is a B. So the pressure of A is always equal to the pressure of B at equilibrium, but condition is a at rest. Another application, and you know, the suppose that if you have a, and okay, and suppose that one level is here, another level is here, okay. So what about the pressure at this point and this point? Okay, suppose that here you have rho 1 density, here you have rho 2 density, this height is a h1, this height is a h2. So this is the A point and this is the B point. You know PA equal to PB. So you can here act the atmospheric pressure, here will act the atmospheric pressure. So the P naught plus rho 1 g h 1, this equal to p naught plus rho 2 g into h 2. So you can write rho 1 g h 1 equal to rho 2 g h 2. So here you can find the relation between the density and height. Okay, so another point is called Pascal law. So as we know, the definition of the Pascal law is, if the pressure in the liquid is changed at any particular point, the change is transmitted to the entire liquid, being diminished in the magnitude. So suppose that one case is, I am going to talk about the Pascal law. Okay, so the Pascal law. So this is the point A. Okay, so what is the pressure at A point equal to? Atmospheric pressure plus rho g, and height is given, this one is h1. Okay, now just pour the another liquid here. Okay, with density rho 2, this was given rho, take rho 1. Okay, this height was h1, this is h2. So what about the now pressure? So pressure at A point will be atmospheric pressure plus rho g rho 2 g h2 plus rho 1 g h1. So p naught plus rho g h1, and you can write here rho g h2. So now you can see this, can I write dash actually? So this is the p a dash, like before pouring the liquid. Now you can see the in the both the cases the pressure is going to change by rho g h2. So if you add any liquid here, okay, then you can see the effect everywhere in the liquid. That is called the Pascal law. So if the pressure in the liquid is changed at any particular point, like here at A point also, you can see the changes by the same amount. That is called Pascal law. And a very important application of Pascal law is a hydraulic jump, hydraulic lift. So here I am going to draw the application of Pascal law. I am taking the horizontal level here, and now we are going to apply the force here, F1. Here is given A1, area is A1. Now if you apply in this way, so the F1 divided by A1, because pressure will be the same. So here force is acting. Suppose that if you have a, generally we use hydraulic lift to lift the vehicle, car, like this, okay, and here cross section area is, you can see, A2, and force acting, that will be the F2. So the F1 by A1, this equal to F2 by A2, because pressure at both the point will be same. And we know here, you can see in this figure, A2 is greater than the A1. So what about the F2? So F2 will be F1 into A2 by A1. So you can see here, F2 is greater than F1. So that is a way, if you apply here some small amount of force, and you can get more amount of force. That is useful for the hydraulic lift. Thank you.